hello and welcome from Columbia, Maryland. We are here live with the Rowland Cup championship match. Two familiar opponents here in Christos FC, Steel Pulse FC. That's right, these two squared off just this past Sunday in the finals of Maryland's National Amateur Cup qualifier, the Stewart Cup. Christos definitely saw the better of that one with a 5-1 victory over the Steel Pulse side. And we'll see, will they continue that level of domination tonight? Will Steel Pulse get some level of revenge? Time will tell. Conditions here a little slick as the rain comes down here at Long Reach High School. We'll see, that might impact the style of play, although both these teams have a lot of experience and certainly will be able to adapt. Christos, right now on your left side of your screen, wearing their famous green and white kits. Christos, I mean Steel Pulse, will start off in their all red and black kits. Moments away from kickoff here. And just to give a little history, the Rowland Cup is Maryland's oldest cup competition. It serves as the open championship, the open amateur cup of Maryland, dating back to 1914. A lot of history here. The winner of this cup will continue on to the Werner Fricker Cup. And actually, both of these teams have already qualified for the Werner Fricker Cup by making it to this championship game. Maryland gets two representatives in both the National Amateur Cup and the Werner Fricker Region 1 Cup. So, in that regard, both these teams have already gotten through, but still a lot to play for. There's a Maryland championship, there's bragging rights on the line, and of course, seeding for that Werner Fricker Cup. As we wait for both teams to line up, we will do the international walkout pre-match ceremony, and then we will be right with you. Thanks for tuning in here on DMV Sports Media Live. Let us know where you're watching from, who you're supporting. Are you a Christos fan, Steel Pulse fan, or maybe just passing through? In which case, welcome. Drop a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more local grassroots football. And we will get right back into each of these teams in just a moment after this pre-match ritual.
Yep. Okay, ready?
Just like that, we are off as we get ready to start this Rowland Cup Finals. Both sides line up with a similar squad to what we saw Sunday, although I do see a few changes in the mix. For Christos, we see Brandon Batika into this lineup, along with a similar starting 11. The other 10 players would be the same. Alejandro Arbeláez is another addition. An experienced, accomplished player. Spent time with the Blast as well as several other sides, UMBC among them. Meanwhile, for Steel Pulse, different goalkeeper in. It will be Appler, Justin Appler, their longtime goalkeeper, will get the start in place of Hollinger. Johnny Ramos, another addition to the side. Number 7 will look to make an impact in the midfield. Aside from that, it's much of the same. We will see if there's any changes made. Unlike the Stewart Cup, the Rowland Cup does allow slightly less rigid substitution policy, so we could see players come and re-enter in this match. As this rain falls down, we will get underway. Both these sides, no stranger, in addition to Sunday's match, squared off many times over the years across all competitions. They played the Maryland Majors years ago and have been in the Maryland Super League since the end of 2021. And really, it always seems to come down to a match between the two, whether in the regular season or in the postseason. And they've also squared off in state cups and even in the Open Cup. Christos, still going in the Open Cup, have earned their spot in the first round against the Richmond Kickers in just a week or two, on March 20th. But for tonight, it's all Rowland Cup, and here we go. Steel Pulse start us off, electing to keep the ball on the turf for now. It is Sinjui sending it back to Appler. Quickly gives it back to his fullback and then sent into the midfield. Christo's taking over now. Sent backwards. And Ali sends it out to Batika. Drawing in the Steel Pulse side. Back to McCleary. Dan McCleary thinks about it before dishing it out to his left. A lovely distribution. Batika finds Belcher now. Belcher down the line. There's Scott's ball in. Appler quick off his line. Able to pounce on the early through ball. Will be tough today to play those direct through balls with the slick turf. See how these teams elect to get balls in. Look for them to play into the corner instead. Steel Pulse now starting their own bit of possession, but possession not retained. Ramsey Haslam turning it over. Here's Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis finding Saunderson, and Saunderson just elects to switch the point of attack. Sense a calmness in Christos' play. Just kind of getting their toes wet, so to speak, and pulling the Steel Pulse side in. However, we see how quickly they can switch it from 0 to 100 as Scott is fouled by Nasiri. And the ball is sent in quickly by Christos. Ball sent forward towards Belcher, but won't get there. And Steel Pulse will have a turn to start their own possession. Here's Boateng, Charles Boateng, finding Emmanuel Oluwesi. Oluwesi didn't start the match on Sunday, but he's been a regular performer for Steel Pulse, and he did come in late in the match. But he's back in the midfield tonight. Here's Sinjui. And now Jude, Stephen Jude has been instrumental in all of Steel Pulse's wins this cup season. I believe he's had an assist or a goal in just about every match he's played in, usually multiple. He had a goal, the lone goal for Steel Pulse on Sunday against Christos on a first-time shot from outside the 18, but wasn't enough to deal with Christos's firepower. They had quite a few top goals themselves. This one will trickle out of bounds. And now Shepherd Lewis will send it in down the line towards Graham. Graham felt he was fouled, but onwards we play. Ryan Graham, longtime veteran player of this Christos side, notched the first goal, which got them on the board with a delightfully timed header on Sunday. And it looks like we'll have another set piece for the Pulse just inside their own territory. Misiri gets us underway, but our center official did not like the spot of the take. And we're gonna see. I think we might see a ball switch. Steel Pulse underway, sends it down the line for Boateng. Boateng finding Jude. And Jude calmly switches the point of attack over to Sinjui. Dangerous ball into the midfield. Steel Pulse do still have possession, but not the most convincing possession. This one finds Nasiri. Nasiri now playing one through. It got past Shepherd Lewis, but Saunderson was there. And now Christos play McCleary. Pressure from Johnny Ramos does yield results. Pulse are back on the ball. And here's Charles Adebayo. Adebayo finds Ramos. Ramos immediately swarms, still going. Sorry, this is Luesi, not Ramos. Ramzi Hassan looking, cutting inside. What can he find? Dishes it off. Siri chipping one. So Paul still on the ball. Though it hasn't been clean. This one served in and easily dealt with by Saunderson. Belcher working, winning the ball back, and fouled in the process. So Christos set piece, quickly taken. No, now it's quickly taken. And I will get my bearings on. It's a bit of a difficult day, both on the pitch and up here in the studio. The rain is certainly coming down here, Columbia, Maryland. Doing our best. As Jude finds a pass, is it on sides? Flag is down. Here is chance for Ramos, and that is a goal. Ramos scores, and that's 1-0 for the Pulse. What a goal by Ramos. We'll take a look at that replay. Christos now signing us underway. Goal down early. How will they respond? On Sunday, it was Pulse who found themselves in a two-goal deficit very early on. Tables turn now. There's a lot to play in this one as Balamo Blanc sends it down the line. Here's Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis sending one in. Dealt with initially, ball not cleared. Pulse unable to work out, but now Ramzi Hassan does have a chance. Finds the front man, Ramos. Ramos's ball just cut out. And now safely back to McCleary. Here's Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis. Running Blanc. And Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis is fouled. And here we go again. Sent forward but picked out. Pulse not able to find Hassan. Christos trying to find weak points in this Steel Pulse side. Elias sends it forward. Scott trying to turn. Steel Pulse getting in the way of one another, and this one will be dealt with by Appler, but a nervy moment for the Pulse. Austin trying to find a turn, but fouled by Tika in the process. Here comes Edu Bayo, playing one forward for Ramos, cut out by Saunderson, and now Christos will start us over in possession. Scott turning well. Of a messy game at the moment. Well won back by Dragicic, and here's Blanc. Blanc trying to find a ball. It is cut out initially and well dealt with by Boateng. There's Blanc. Watch out for his speed going forward. Finds a ball in for Shepherd-Lewis, goalkeeper off his line, and well taken by Shepherd-Lewis, but Edo Bayo was back. Well flicked on by Diarra Zumana, and there's a foul coming. A hard foul, but Diarra Zumana back on his feet, and we will have a set piece inside Christos territory. Let's take a look at the replay real quick.
So just do nothing right now.
Yeah. Sent in by the Pulse. Here's Boateng taking his time for Oluwesi. Gets involved. Working forward, running Ramzi Hassan. Hassan distributes out wide. And pulse now in no hurry. Siri dancing, but tackle comes in from Belcher. Now sent over to this near side, Stephen Jude. Get involved. There's an errant pass, well cut out by Graham, but only partially. And Graham still there, working hard for his team. This could be dangerous. Pulse had bodies forward and could have been caught out, but comes to nothing. And Christos will start from scratch. And sent out for Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis and will trickle out of bounds in the end. Boateng sends one in. Well turned. Now forward for Ramos, but cut out by Saunderson. There's a tackle from Sinjui, but it's deemed to be a foul. Take a look at this replay. This foul. Just inside Pulse territory. See how Christo selects to attack this one. I usually like to play these on the ground, but slick conditions could test Appler. This one is sent into the box. Appler stays on his line, but it is well dealt with by Diarra. Boateng does get a touch on this. Forward, Ramos is fighting and does win it. Johnny Ramos on the ground, and his ball is cut out by Saunderson. Arbeláez dishes one forward. Pulse back in possession now. Shepherd-Lewis doing oh so well. Slaloming forward, and looks like there's a handball, potentially a foul. It is going to be Arbeláez to send this one into the box after that handball. About 35 yards out from goal. Certainly would be a good opportunity to dish one into the box, and it is sent in. Appler gets a hand to it. Not confidently cleared, but did enough. It looks like it came off Christos player last. Appler will take the goal kick now. It is one now by Christos. Sinjui finds Hassan. Hassan sending it backwards. And this one does fall out of bounds. Christos throw on the far side. Saunderson, lots of space in front of him. Looking, finding the midfield. Tons of space to turn for Belcher. Here's Scott. Dragicic dropping deep. Christos Christos building some possession. And as soon as I say that commentator's curse, Steel Pulse get on the ball, but not doing well holding it themselves. There's Blanc down the line. Belcher sends it back to Blanc. Relentless pressure from this Pulse side. And here's Oluwesi's ball. Hassan. Johnny Ramos doing enough to get a piece of that one. And it is free kick in favor of the Pulse just inside Christos territory. Sent in to Oluwesi. Now here's Jude sending it across. Long ball attempt, those rarely work against this Christos side, although the second ball may yet yield results. Here's a ball played into the far post, kept in bounds by Nasiri. And here's Ramsey Hassan's ball, a dangerous one, not one.
Get R, and you can do the replay right now.
Let's take a look at this, it seemed like a really dangerous ball in. Christos send in the goal kick. And now play one through. Keeper does come off his line well. Quickly, he'll send it out to his right. Pulse inviting pressure in. Now sending it down that line. Lee working with Saunderson. Open up a little bit more space, and here is Scott dropping deep. Pressure is on, and a free kick goes the way of Christos. Significant disagreement from the Pulse bench, but there was contact from behind. Saunderson playing it in for Lee. A lazy ball cut out. Cody Albrecht, another longtime player, leader in this back line for Christos alongside Saunderson. And there is a foul called. Opportunity for Christos to play another one into the box. The last delivery was promising. Watch out for Albrecht. He has a dangerous delivery. He's responsible for Steel Pulse's exit from the US Open Cup this past qualifiers with free kick. Albrecht's ball driven low, but easily dealt with this time by Pulse. Pulse doing well, trying to find a counterattack. A little bit sloppy. This one is switched over to Zumana Diarra. Diarra looking for a ball, well cut out by Batika.
Come on, guys, you gotta be better.
Foul We'll see Christos start us on the ground. Is Albrecht over for Saunderson. And back over to that left side. Uncharacteristic mistake from Albrecht. Here's Hassan. Lethargic passing. See which team snaps out of it first. This one sent into the top of the 18. Trying to find any opening in this Christos line. I'm not able to this time. This one's sent over. And now backwards. Here's Charles Edobayel. Good pulse captain finding Boateng. Boateng, tons of space in front of him. This one sent into the corner. Delightful ball, but well defended on that far side by Batika. And here comes the green and white down that far side, hugging the touch. Sent across, but Edobayo able to get behind it. Looks like we'll probably have a corner coming. Well, this has been one strong suit for Christos. As much as it has been a weak side for Steel Pulse, they have been vulnerable on set pieces, especially corner kicks in the past. Keep an eye on that in this rainy day here in Columbia, Maryland. Plenty of potential targets. Look for Scott Saunderson to get involved on this outswinger. Here's the delivery, sent high. Not dealt with initially, but partially cleared. Sent out to that far side. And now backwards. Blocked out of bounds for another Christos throw. And we do have a player down for potential head injury. Meanwhile, it looks like Merriam will come on for Scott. Jamie Merriam scored a delightful goal at the end of this past Sunday's affair from about 35 yards out. Take a look at that highlight on our Instagram or Twitter page, but for now he'll look to make an impact up top. It looks like the player is going to be all right, so Christos will send it back. There's the delivery and a little too much juice on that pass. No takers there. Boateng down the line. Not a bad attempt at the turn, but Christos will send it in. Here's Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis. Battle in the midfield. Siri getting the better. And here's Ramsey Hassan's ball forward for the streaking Ziara. Ziara Zumana not able to handle that cleanly. There is a handball in the mix. Christos start us off. And there is a foul against the Pulse. Dominic Cologne rising up from that contact. Looks like he'll be all right. Cologne also scoring in Sunday's affair with a delightful set piece just outside the 18. And there's Dragicic sending one in, but well dealt with by Pulse. Sent down the line, and no takers there, just miscommunication between Jude Diarzumana and Ramos, who was supposed to be there, and here comes Christos the other side. just carrying and then finding the midfield. Down the line, beautiful ball from Lee, and here's Eli Belcher. Belcher sending it across, no one dealing with it initially, and Pulse are able to control that one. And forward, and not distributed as well as Ramos would have liked. There is a tackle on that far side. We will see Christos throw. Down the line from Christos. Into the corner, sent across. No one was there. It will be a Pulse throw in the corner. Down the line from Pulse, well flicked on. And it will be a Pulse throw on this near side. Boateng will send it in, looking back to Adebayo. This one down the line, easily cut out by Christos. Saunderson. Saunderson and Albrecht working together. Start this attack. Here comes Christos on that far side, down the line, into the corner, and a little too much juice. He ran out of real estate. Will be a goal kick for Appler. Kick coming. Appler sends everyone forward. Sent into the midfield. Well flicked on. Now sent into touch for a Christos throw. We'll have another change coming for the green and white. On the block steps off as Toga Katsuma steps on. A lot of depth in both of these sides. We'll see if Toga is able to make an impact here. There is Boateng. Boateng sending it outside and now. Heavy pressure from Christos yields results. And they will slow it down. Which does allow Steel Pulse to get bodies. Goal side, it's going to be a Christos throw. Possible high boot called late. And it will be set piece coming out for the Pulse. Down Here is Appler to send this one forward. Well flicked on by Nasiri. And here's Oluwesi. Roatan cutting it inside, working well with Nasiri. Now Jude's ball is good. Hassan, Nasiri now. Jude forcing Christos out. Can they endure the pressure? Roatan cutting, finding a little space. Sent forward for Oluwesi, and Oluwesi deemed to be offsides there. Saunderson sends it across to his counterpart, old Albrecht. And now Saunderson again. Possible foul. Foul is called on Zumana. Saunderson will send it back to Albrecht, who will switch the point of attack. And a pulse throw on the far side. Took a touch off the Christos man. This one sent down the line into the midfield. There is Saunderson, but Pulse able to clear their lines and now back all the way to McCleary. Albrecht finding lots of space in the midfield. This one well cut out by Sinjui. Hassan and Nasiri working together. Losing out is Hassan. Here comes Christos. Again, the conditions certainly impacting things. This is a totally different ball game from what we saw on Sunday. There's a team finding their rhythm. I think Christos has been particularly impacted, but still lots of time to play as we enter the 36th minute. We'll have another substitution as Henry Scott will replace Eli Belcher. Looks like it's Hassan who's off. Christos winning it back. Sot sends it over to Toga. Toga turning well. Now Shepherd Lewis trying to round the corner. Working against Boateng. Here's Shepherd Lewis finding a pass and repelled at that near post. Really well done by Demetrius Shepherd Lewis. Minute and a chance for Christos to send one in on this slick day. Elias is there, but will make way. Here's the in-swinger. sent to the far post, and a foul coming out for the benefit of the Pulse. Looks like Edubio will send it out. I don't think Pulse are going to try to play on the ground for this one, as Edubio just lumps it forward in the air. Contested and well won by Christos. There's Oluwesi putting a pass and sent backwards. This one sent forward, but Saunderson has those all day. Very strong in the back is Saunderson. And a Pulse throw. Boateng will make his way forward. On the line. Foul going against the Pulse. Going against Lawal Murtala. And now Christos sends it in. Here's Cody Albrecht. Possible long ball coming from Saunderson. Pulled down by Merriam. And there is a foul called over on this near side. Well, it seems like a good time to respond.
Hey, how's it going?
A few of the messages in the chat. Finals pick for MDV Cup. I mean, seen these teams a couple times in the last few days. I would have to say Christos Steel Pulse until I'm proven otherwise. Christos Steel Pulse across most tournaments. Of course, I'm sure there are plenty out there who would say Toros could throw their name in the hat, and we will see. Soon enough, Gian Hawks as well would have a claim. But that's my pick for right now. Someone else asked, since when have I started streaming matches? I don't remember exactly when I started streaming them, but it's been a few years. I started filming in 2021 and really started figuring out the streaming thing. But for right now, Christo's coming forward. Scott sending it out wide. Here's Toko Katsuma cutting back inside. And now back for Shepard Lewis. Joe Paul send it out wide. Cutting inside, really well done by Demetrius Shepard Lewis. Taking it, and there is a penalty kick called. Penalty kick coming. We'll take a look at the replay, but really well worked series of play from Demetrius Shepard Lewis. So powerful on the offensive and defensive side of the ball, earning his team that penalty kick. Let's take a look at this replay now. Well, we missed the replay, but you can just rewind it back. These games live on here forever, so you can just go back and see for yourself. It's not gonna change anything as far as this game goes. There is no VAR, but we will see. Penalty kick coming now. It is Jamie Merriam in the rain against Justin Appler. Can Merriam equalize this scoreline before the half? Here we go. Oh, there it is. Calmly finished by Merriam. Yes. And a great goal. Level at one. Huge momentum boost for Christos. Take a look at this replay now. There is the Siri now. Going back to Sinjui and Edubio. Will Pulse look to try to get one before the half, or are they going to stay content with the scoreline right now? Sending one forward into the corner. Johnny Ramos creating problems. But Saunderson doing really well and eliciting the foul. Looks like we will have 1 minute added of stoppage time here at the end of this first half as the rain picks up. Albrecht sending his players forward, looking for a long ball. Cut out initially by the Pulse. And now Edobio finds Boateng. Boateng under pressure just has to lump it forward. Beautiful flick on. This could be problems. Lawal Murtala. And out of bounds. Looks like we do have a head injury behind the ball. Ramos still down. I hope that he's all right. Ramos back on his feet. And we will make a substitution for Ramos. So no substitute coming on. Looks like Ramos will try to go back in a few moments. But we're just about at the end of the half anyways. Pulse with the throw down in the corner. Murtala sending it in. Boateng lumping it into the box, but easily dealt with by Saunderson. Here's Boateng. Let me get down the line. And out of bounds. That will take us to the end of the half. Score of one apiece. Steel Pulse finding their way onto the score sheet early in this one, but an equalizer late in the half from Merriam off penalty kick. Certainly a lot more in this one to determine a winner. We'll see you back for the second 45 minutes in just a few minutes. Don't go anywhere and send this link to all your friends. We will see you in just a bit. We'll be right back. Hello and welcome back, football fans. Apologies for the delay. Some technical difficulties, but we're back. Christos working along their back line. Now finding the midfield. Nasiri gets the tackle in. We play on. Here's Ramos giving it away. Physical in there from both sides, and this time it will go the way of Christos, much to the disappointment of the Steel Pulse players. Christos playing it on the ground, but we'll send it back. A few substitutes on from each side. We'll get into that in just a moment. For right now, it's fast and furious. This one's sent into the box. Chance, and second ball pounced on by Justin Appler. Well taken first time from Scott and almost slid through the arms of Appler. Going down the line from Murtala. And a foul. Called against Oluwesi. Sent in and wide. Rain is really coming down now here in Colombia. Foul going against Oluwesi this time. Good distribution from McCleary. Now sent across. Is driving and cut out at the back. This is ball into the corner, dealt with partially, and corner kick to come for Christos. Opening goal was Johnny Ramos' goal for the Pulse, and equalized later in the half by a penalty kick from Jamie Merriam. If you're just tuning in, this is the second half of the Rowland Cup Finals. Ball sent in, partially cleared, and now Pulse do find a little breathing room. Sent back to McCleary. Ramos forcing the ball out wide. And this one almost breaks down Pulse's midfield, but able to win it back. Oluwesi out wide. Cut and blocked. There's a challenge from Hassan. Hassan's ball doesn't find its intended target. Sent backwards now along the 18. This is cut out. Here comes Ramsey Hassan. Space in front of him will slow it down and cut inside. Finding Nasiri. Crunching tackle from Belcher and Christos the other way. Henry Scott, under pressure, is fouled in a Christos set piece inside their own half. There is Albrecht sending one into the 18. Boateng doing well to get ahead to it. Here's Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis playing it down the line. Sari sending it out to Ramzi Hassan. Here's Sinjui, and it looks like we will have a discussion between Arbeláez and Nasiri, something after the play. We didn't catch that. This one comes forward and outside. Still on the line, and we are still playing. Christos sending it into the midfield. Dangerous. Christos able to retain possession, finding Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis in space. Shepherd-Lewis's ball into the box. Just wide, but still in bounds. Here's Scott. And a foul going against Scott this time. Sent forward. A foul called against Dragicic this time. It was great to see all of our loyal fans in the chat. I see Alec Gabarete. Congratulations on a huge win in the MDC VSA Virginia State Cup on Sunday. At a pleasure covering that match. Gabarete, one of the influential players in that one. Meanwhile, Steel Pulse under heavy pressure, trying to build from the back. Despite these conditions, Steel Pulse finding a little space forward. Driving is Nasiri. Nasiri out wide. This one sent in. Shouts for a penalty kick, not given. And what a goal from the Pulse! Beautiful finish from Johnny Ramos. That's two goals for Ramos. And a beautifully finished volley out of the air into McCleary's net. Let's take a look at this replay now. We are back in play. If you're just tuning in, it is Steel Pulse leading by a score of 2-1. Two Johnny Ramos goals here. Been the difference. Christos earned their goal at the end of the first half on a Jamie Merriam penalty kick. This one is sent out wide to Lee. Alex Lee going back. Finding McCleary. Yeah. Saunderson driving forward, long ball into the corner, well dealt with by the Pulse. And a foul given. This one's set long, well won by Albrecht. Beautiful play from the Paul, sent forward for Ramos, and Christos looking to play out. Here's Lee in the corner. Lee finds Scott, and Scott is fouled. Yellow card for Nasir. Nasir will have to be careful now. Red card for either side would be catastrophic. Nasir is a key player in that midfield for the Pulse. Here's Albrecht. Sending it over to the far side. Christos taking their time. Forward, here's Blanc into the corner. Pulse, do get a touch. But a dangerous ball in from Christos, and we'll have a Christos throw on this near side. Oh, misplayed by Albrecht, and Ramos is on it, but Cody Albrecht doing well to tone for his initial mistake. Beautiful pass, lots of space in this midfield. Edubio cuts it out, and now Pulse trying to find their midfield unsuccessfully. There's Lee driving into the corner and taken down, but no foul has been called. On the ground, here comes Nasiri. Sorry, that's Johnny Ramos distributing into the corner. Cutting, still going, goalkeeper off his line and into the side netting. That's a goal kick coming out. One sent in, just wide of goal. We have a goalkeeping switch. Thomas Potts will replace Dan McCleary. McCleary doing well in between Christos pipes, but Potts equally capable. From down the line. Sent forward by Christos quickly. Now into the corner. Here's Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis. Sent on the ground. Kept alive now by Scott. And out of bounds. Did take a touch off the Pulse player before. Making its way through. There's Belcher. Now Albrecht playing one into the top of the 18. Christos under some pressure. We'll just look back to find Potts. Potts quickly switching the point of attack, and here's Lee. This game is certainly spread out. A lot of space in this midfield. Christos go back to Potts. Effective clearance from the Pulse. No players forward. Dragicic will just turn it around. Long ball easily cut out. But the second ball, not a good one. And here's Blanc playing one in behind. Appler will easily get onto this one and take it to his feet. Forcing Arbeláez in. Rappler just playing long. Ramos has been Steel Pulse's shining star today, working very hard up top and scoring the two goals. Sent in, Oluwesi controlling and sending it back. Here's Hassan. Hassan losing out, and what can Christos find? Blanc, ball at his feet, does play the pass long and will drift all the way back to Appler. Will kill more valuable time off the clock. Appler's ball cut out of the air, and second ball won by Hassan. Down the line for Nasiri. This one forward, but Potts off his line in a good position. Potts able to impact the game early. Well, early from his perspective. Here is bad turnover. Nasiri sending it off wide, sent back across and over. Take a look at the replay. It's good right now. See how Christos playing from the back. Sent forward for Burkholder and a great overlapping run from Lee. Lee trying around the corner. And there was some extracurriculars there on the near side. And plenty for the referee to sort out. I'm not a bitch. Yeah, you're right. I'm not a bitch. 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 I'm not a b Players chopping it up in there, but looks like we will have a decision. Will be a set piece coming forward for the Pulse. No cautions made in this instance. Long ball sent down the line. Christos playing one forward, cut out well by Boateng. Boateng down the line. Here's Pulse sending in a long shot, which takes a touch on its way and a corner kick coming. In swinger for Diarra Zumana. Diarra Zumana's delivery just over in the series head, and it will be a goal kick coming out. Quickly taken by Potts. Split one into the middle. Graham working hard. And a handball not called. Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis driving and taken down. Definite foul. Set piece in a dangerous spot for Christos. Well inside Pulse territory in this rainy evening. In early March here in Columbia, Maryland. Watch for Saunderson, Lee, and others to get forward.
Alright, cool, we good now.
There's a delivery into the box. A little far and over goal. A little too much juice on that one. Pulse will see a goal kick coming out. Looks like Graham will be replaced by Merriam up top. Right, push ball into the midfield. Tested and foul going against Steel Pulse. Looks like Saunderson will stay back this time. Christos play on the ground, sent into the corner. Shepherd-Lewis still going. It's Toka Katsuma. And this one comes off the referee but stays with the Pulse, so onwards we go.
Hey,
Send forward. And Ramos dishes it out. Wide. Here's Hassan. Hassan cutting inside. And backwards for Oluwesi. Delicious ball forward. Siri still going. Sending one across the box. Chance for a shot and over Potts' goal. Beautiful build up from the pulse and didn't execute that time.
I can't even see it all from me. That's why I'm just going to say, whenever you think it's up, I can only see the camera. I can't see what's on the screen.
Yeah. Big shout out to my colleague, Monte Johnson, in the booth handling our replay tonight. Figuring it out on the fly. This one long from Christos, well won by Edo Bio. Sent outside. Up forward, Ramos touching it on and looking to get on the return ball. A little too much. Christos will take it the other way. There's Arbelaez out wide for Saunderson. On the ground for Ramos. Ramos taken down, last man. And a definite card. We'll see what color it is. Red as the last man. Albrecht's day is done in a set piece in a dangerous area. It's a tough break for Albrecht, classy player. I mean, it was really milliseconds that determined whether he won that challenge or didn't quite get there. And fortunately, he's on the wrong side of it. So Christos now playing with 10 men. And a set piece for Steel Pulse to boot. Couple of potential takers over here for the Pulse. It's Garo Zomana and Steven Jude standing over it. On this slick day, Thomas Potts will have his hands full as he directs the wall into position. Comes the delivery, repelled by the wall. Still contested. Arbelaez dropping deep. Pulse orchestrating a shot just wide of goal, and it'll be a goal kick to come after a couple of nervy moments in Christos' back line. This one's sent in. Forward, Ajaigu drops it back. I don't think Ajaigu and his teammates were on the same page with that one, but in the end, it does yield fruit. Ramos was almost able to get on the end. Backwards from the pulse. Pressure sees a mistake from Steel Pulse. A couple of substitutions stepping on. Blanc and Cologne stepping on. Belcher playing it outside. Good ball from Dragicic. Here's Nasiri. looking for Hassan, not finding. This one just about squeaks through. Boateng clears it. Linesman had raised his flag. We'll see, is this going to be a Christos throw or a seal pulse? Set piece on the ground. I think it is a Christos throw. Here comes the throw from Christos. Long ball. And almost caused problems for the Pulse. Oluwesi is able to get it forward, but not fully cleared. Christos have a set piece for Arbeláez to take. Arbeláez's ball. Sent over into the corner, flicked on, and trickles out of bounds. Goal kick to come. Looks like Murtala will come on.
Boys, 13 minutes, let's go. We need one.
13 to play in this Rowland Cup final. If you're just tuning in, it is 2-1 in favor of the Pulse. Oluwesi making way as Appler sends all his players forward. Not dealt with, and Pulse have a little space on this far side. Will earn a throw. Laid on the ground. Sent in, and not what Ajaigu had in mind. It's a good ball forward from Potts. Finding his front man. Merriam doing so well to hold up that pass, and now Arbeláez. This one bounces up and hits Sinjui in the hand. The handball. Set piece for Christos. Very dangerous area. Cologne standing over it. Here comes the delivery. Cologne. Off delivery in a dangerous area. First ball won by Steel Pulse. Back in. Flag stays down, played high, goalkeeper off his line, punched, but not fully dealt with. And the Christos players get in the way of one another. Pulse finding some space forward. Can they find Ramos? Elects to hold up that pass, and probably the right move with the goal advantage. Christos, meanwhile, relentless and winning it back. Forward again from the Pulse. Into the corner. Good battle and well won by Christos. Right back and forth right now. Here's Arbeláez. On the ground from Hassan. Hassan and Nasiri having a go at one another. Sometimes it's like that when you play with your friends. Meanwhile, on the far side, Demetrius Shepherd-Lewis trying to surgically pick out a pass, but not finding enough space. There's a play down behind the ball for the Pulse. Said Ubiel, the captain. Certainly, we'll see some stoppage time for this one. Back on his feet now, Charles Edubio. My apologies for the disappearance of the scoreboard. We got a strange contraption set up just because of the weather. I didn't notice that, my apologies, but we are in the 82nd minute here. Steel Pulse leading by a score of 2-1. About 8 to play, plus certainly some stoppage time to be added on top of that. Here's Jaigu driving into space, finding his pass. Ramsey Hassan cutting inside and sending it backwards to Jude. Siri out to the far side. And now to Siri. Here comes much better possession from the Pulse, taking their time and utilizing their man advantage and goal advantage. Played in, but not a great delivery. Christos easily able to deal with it. Relies back for Potts. Not the best touch from Potts, and off the hook. A dangerous moment as that one slicked off of Potts' foot, but ended up over the line. Goal kick to come. Potts sending one high into this sky. Not cleanly won. Down the line. Just finding Arbeles. And this one will be Steel Pulse throw. Down the line, flicked on, but Potts will get there. It's a goal kick. My eyes betray me. I thought Potts had just sent that one right in front of a Steel Pulse player, but it had already traveled over the end line. Shepherd Lewis down the line. Will be a Pulse throw. Another substitution coming for the Pulse. Olerwesi stepping on. There it is, Ajaigu finding Olerwesi into the corner for Ramsey Hassan. Hassan finding the pass. Well defended from Dominic Colon, and throw coming for Christos. Down the line from Christos. Good work from Jamie Merriam, and out of bounds will be a Steel Pulse throw. Not a lot of time left in this one. False using every bit of gamesmanship possible to delay. Ramos sends it back, and a foul against Ramos on the line. Good sportsmanship from Cologne. A set piece here inside Christos territory. And down the line, here's Hassan. Crunching tackle and off of the Steel Pulse player. No. Well, I guess the referee saw it differently. Looks like, no, it will be a Christos throw. Well, looks like I'm wrong twice. It is Steel Pulse to send it in. Here comes Ajaigu's throw into the 18. Shot coming and well held by Potts. That was Potts sending one long. One by Boateng. And it comes down to the Christos midfield. Shepherd Lewis able to intervene. Togo Katsuma between a sea of red shirts, able to work it out to Dominic Cologne. Cologne with a little space in front of him. Sending one forward. Appler off his line and beautiful delivery from Cologne. Looks like there is a corner to come. Appler got a piece of that one, so they say. No love lost here as we enter the late stages of this championship match. In swinger from Christos to the back post. Sent away. And here comes the Pulse. Ball in behind. Thomas Potts in a good position. This one not the best delivery. And here's Ramzi Hassan. Fouled by Miriam. Nine, 89th minute now. 1 minute natural to play plus stoppage in this Rowland Cup final. If we were tied at the end of regulation, we would go right to penalty kicks. But right now, Christos down a man and down a goal. Need to find something in his last few minutes. Sent in for Ajaigu. Come forward. Ramos trying to find a dummy. And there is a foul, this time going against Masiri, and his day is done. That's his second yellow, so could get interesting now in the end stage of this game. 10v10. Christos sending everyone forward now. Late, they need this goal. Potts balls, good one. One, and claimed by Appler. Nervy moment for Steel Pulse, but well held. Under pressure, and Appler will send his players forward. Sent in the direction of Ramos, but easily won by Christos. Togo Katsuma driving, trying to line up a shot, but Pocket is picked. 4 minutes of stoppage time coming. Burkholder doing well to take the ball away from a streaking Ramsey Haslam. Yeah, we're into stoppage. Like I said a minute ago, four to play. Not sure exactly how long has elapsed into stoppage. Down the line now from Pulse. Flicked on by Boateng and offsides. Sending one forward. Flicked on. Christos calling for the handball, but not called. Potts doing well under pressure from Ramos. And a dangerous foul. Yellow card to going against Miriam, and there's another red card for Christos. Down to nine men. Tough luck for Miriam. Setback for Christos, but the question remains, can they find the equalizer? Easily claimed by Potts. Flicked on. And offsides. Ramos was behind the back line. Here comes Christos. Henry Scott trying to distribute one. Shots of handball. Not given. And a throw. Comes the delivery from Burkholder. Watch out for this flick throw. Flip throw coming from Burkholder at this crucial moment. Here it is, sent into the box. Not dealt with initially, but Christos dropping back to regain this one. Sent to Potts. And now Scott sending one long. Flicked on well, and Edobio clears his lines.
My legs don't work as well.
Yeah.
Okay. I got it.
There's Potts sending one back into Steel Pulse territory. Another throw for Christos. This one high. Flicked on well. And there is a clearance just wide of goal, and that could be it. Goal kick to come. We still continue into stoppage time. Four was initially added, but more stoppage has occurred throughout injury time. Jaigu sending it forward, and offsides again is Ramos. On As Potts sends one forward, but that is the ball game, and Steel Pulse are your 2024 Rowland Cup champions. Score of 2-1 against Christos. These two always quality opponents. Steel Pulse get a bit of revenge for Sunday, but both these sides will be on to the Werner Fricker Cup and the National Amateur Cup. So congratulations to both Christos and Steel Pulse. A job well done to get to this point. Goal scorers today, Ramos twice for Steel Pulse and Merriam for Christos. Christos down to 9 men by the end of this. And meanwhile, Steel Pulse picking up a red of their own. So an eventful evening, but plenty of action in store for these two. As we mentioned, still part of those two tournaments and still each going in the MDV Cup. And of course, Christos will play Richmond Kickers March 20th in the US Open Cup. Them having qualified for that first round, could we see another historic run from Christos? Definitely be looking to follow that. And then of course, March 24th, Maryland Super Soccer League kicks off. We'll see these two teams matched up before long. So thanks for tuning in. We will have the trophy presentation ceremony in just a moment. Stay tuned for that.
Hey, Marcus, watch it. Hey, come in. Come in. Hey. Make your notice. Ready to come. Do this. Time out.
our trophy presentation. Fran McGrath discussing 110-year history of this Rowland Cup, named after Henry Rowland, Englishman, helped start the tournament back in 1914. A lot of history behind this cup, as well as Baltimore and Maryland soccer. We certainly appreciate you tuning in for this cup final. We're live on DMV Sports Media. Sanders. Receiving his trophy. MSSA President Tony Falcone and Secretary Cup Commissioner Fran McGrath. On behalf of Christos FC, runners up for this year's Rowland Cup Championship. And now Charles Edubio receiving the first place trophy. On behalf of Steel Pulse, alongside Justin Appler. Classy affair between two great teams, two great coaches, and two great clubs. Always a pleasure tuning into this one, even in these abysmal conditions. We made it through. And now, stick around for Steel Pulse's celebration before we tune out here.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. We are the champions.
tuning in here live on DMB Sports Media on YouTube. We'll see you this Sunday for more MDB Cup action, APL action, and soon enough, much more.
Thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses.
All right, we out.